Hello, my beautiful friends. Thanks so much for tuning in. So in today's video, I want to show you what we're doing for Christmas. And I am doing a lot of the things, but all of them are indoors in my home. And there's a few reasons why I'm doing all the things. So I want to share that with you and just kind of, you know, show you what I'm doing and hope to encourage you or give you any ideas that will help you to do Christmas school in your home. So let's get started. Okay, so I'm doing two curriculums, yes, two, and you might think it's a lot, but you really just kind of do what's best for you and like not all the things. You don't have to do everything in the curriculum. So I am enjoying these two because they have two different perspectives for Christmas, and one of them was sent to me for my review, so I'm excited to share that with you. And also, we are doing two different Advents and kind of just gonna share with you what I'm doing and where I get it from. Let me show you. I'm going to flip the camera. I'm going to show you my Christmas cart because I transformed it just for Christmas. What I'm decided to do this year is to take the whole month of December off just to do Christmas things. Considering the fact that I'm still doing a curriculum, it works out for us because we're still doing writing. We're still doing reading. We are doing, there's some history here and a lot of research and stuff like that. So we are doing school. It's just Christmas themed. So I'm excited about that. Right now, I'm in lesson two on both curriculums, so I'm excited to share that with you. Kind of like, even if you watch this video today, which is, where are we, December 2nd, you can still buy these things and download them and print them, whatever you want to do. You still have time. You don't have to start it exactly on December 1st. So I wanted to encourage you that in case you just, I wish I would have known about that earlier, but no, you can start this now or even this week, whenever you watch this video, in the beginning of December, because you can also choose to do this throughout the weekend sometimes to catch up a little bit if you want, or even skip one lesson if you need to, or kind of combine two lessons. Whatever you want to do. It's very flexible. A lot of fun is involved. There's baking. There's traditions to be made, new traditions. There's cards to be made, encouragement to pass out. Random acts of kindness. I love all the things. So that's what we're doing. And what I love about this is that it kind of works out because we're stuck home, you know? So I am kind of keeping my day as busy as possible with my children because we're all, you know, we're kind of stuck home. There's a very less little things to do this year. A lot of the things that we have planned that we do every year is canceled this year. So as sad as my heart is, I'm also looking forward to just being a very quiet, calm down and fun Christmas here at home. This plan to do these two curriculums, to be able to fill our day with fun, but at home, is the way to go this year. So I wanna share that with you. I also wanted to share with you where I got them from. I'm gonna link everything down below. And if you have any questions, as usual, I always say, talk to me in the comments. I would love to hear from you. So let me show you. So this is one of our little Advent countdowns. One of my sweet friends sent it to us last year. And here is our Christmas cart. Here's where our curriculums are. And actually, instead of two, I'm gonna say I'm doing three, but I'll explain to you why three in a minute. You might be like thinking I'm crazy. These are some of the books affiliated with one of the curriculums. And then this is a manger, actually a stable that one of my sons is doing that goes with the curriculum. So just so you know why that's there. And then we have my morning menu. And then we have activities. This is my calendar. We have activities here. Coloring and different things, and then we have more like games and other things here that I have put together for them. So let me show you what I have so you can see. Okay, so the first curriculum is by Gather Round. This is the Christmas unit this year. This is my teacher's manual. I wanted to kind of give you a quick flip through and just show you the lessons that it has. So this is a shorter curriculum. It has 12 lessons as opposed to 20. And then how you would do it is do four lessons a week, then you have four lessons for the other week and four lessons for the third week. So you're working on three weeks of lessons, okay? And then we have Mary, Joseph, John the Baptist, a census, a star, shepherds, wise men, the great plan, hidden meanings part one, hidden meanings part two, Christmas around the world, and traditions. So all that is covered under this unit. Then there's the appendix has songs that you're learning,
with the kiddos, and it has printables. It has recipes. So you'll be doing baking, you're doing cards, you're doing songs. It's a little bit of everything, and it's so much fun. This is a letter for the teacher, for the parent. And this is a resuscitation passage. They have it in three different translations. So I decided to do ESV. I love ESV. And this is something that you would read to your child every day in hopes that we either memorize it as a family or just kind of keeping the theme of the Bible, you know, the whole story of the birth of Jesus every morning. So we would do that together first. They always include a book list, which I love. These are the ones that I have right now in my cart. I'm not doing all the books because I'm doing another curriculum too with other books. And then I have my own books. So those are the books. This is a great book list. And then it gives you supplies that you need for each week. Week one is for all the baking. Week two, there's also cookie decorating. And week three is a box that we're doing. I forgot what this is for. Let's see. It's another baking recipe. These are the lessons and the resources that you need, or the supplies. So like for lesson one, you need scissors, paint, colored pencils, and so forth. And gives everything you need so you can be prepared. I love this little cute little Christmas at a glance. I've been writing my traditions with my kiddos. And then this is events, what we're gonna do. Of course, COVID has my thing completely blank there. Shopping list, I'm not using this, but it's adorable. Okay, so the first story is Mary, the mother of Jesus. And this is the lesson that we did already. So I wanted to show you, it kind of tells you, this is the day at a glance, what you're going to be covering. Resuscitation, a gift to Jesus. The boys are making this handmade gift to Jesus. And then we're doing the Christmas song, which is Away in a Manger. We're learning that one. And then Make a Stable. So each week we're learning one song. And then before you begin, it goes over some things, some instructions. And then you read the story about Mary and so forth with your kids. You read the Bible. You have questions here and so forth. And then while the kids are working on their pages, I also have my own thing here. I have Let's Connect, where we're writing different traditions or memories that we have enjoyed and had during Christmas that we remember. So we wrote some memories down, and then the boys worked on their notebooks. So these are the boys' notebooks here. I'm just gonna show you really quick lesson three. So lesson three will be tomorrow, okay? The pre-reader always has a coloring page that they get to work on while you're reading your story. And then they have the activities. So tomorrow is baking day. We're gonna go over the recipe, which is great. Look for all the ingredients. He gets to color another page here that talks about the lesson. And then there's more reflection here. So this one says, every week we are going to spend some time planning out RAK. So that's a random act of kindness. So we are doing a random act of kindness that we're planning out. I'm so excited. I cannot wait to do this with them tomorrow. And it says, think about things, something kind you could do for someone else to share God's love. So I love that. So we're gonna be working on that. And then it goes to lesson four. So the pre-reader only has three pages, and sometimes literally just coloring. And then this is my middle schooler. Tomorrow he has to do a recipe thing. He's gonna double the recipe. I love it. So it says make 24 as opposed to 12. And then you double the recipe here. So he does some math, which I love. And it says here, double or triple the recipe, and then convert the recipe to a different form of measurement. That's another fun thing that he has to do tomorrow. So I'm excited for that. And they're doing gingerbread cookies. It's called Rebecca's Chewy Gingerbread Cookies. And Rebecca's the creator of this curriculum. The recipe's here. It tells them how to do it. I love that. And then instructions again, but they're actually fruits of the spirit. So actually what JL's doing, it's fruits of the spirit. And then he does the random act of kindness. So JL has one more page. This is his random act of kindness page here. So he has an additional page because he is my middle schooler, and he's gonna be working on the fruits of the spirit tomorrow. So I'm excited about that too as well. And then my early readers, Jonah, he is my third grader, but he's in an early reading stage still. So this is his third lesson. Again, he's going over the recipe. And for him, it says Rebecca's Tree Recipe Cookies. He has to, it says, before you begin reading this recipe, pull out a teaspoon, a tablespoon, and some measuring cups. So we're gonna bring all those things to the table. Then if you want, make the cookies or make your own recipe as a family. So we're gonna be discussing the measurements for Jonah. And then over here is the ingredients, and it says tips. This is all the ingredients. It's going to be talking about the instructions, the ingredients. So all the kids have instructions and ingredients on their books, on their journals. And then over here, he's also working on the fruits of the spirit. So we're going to do this lesson together while JJ does some coloring. JJ's working on the love. So JJ was, love was his fruit of the spirit right here. So he's going to be coloring that while we read and we go through our fruits of the spirit lesson. And then the Jonah's also working on, oh wait, I hit number four here, random act of kindness. So he also has to go and think and write or draw what he wants his random act of kindness to be. So he's doing ideas. He's going to be writing ideas here. And that's pretty much lesson three for all of them. So I'm excited about that. Again, tomorrow's baking day. And the lesson three I'll show you here, we're going to be covering is Joseph. I'm sorry. This was lesson two. Let me go to lesson three. So lesson three in my teacher manual, we're going to be doing John the Baptist. We do the recitation, the song, recitation, song, which is Away in the Manger, baking day, the cookies, fruit of the spirit, and then random act of kindness. So I cross all these off when I'm done doing their lessons. So I love this so much. This is what we do in the morning, right before lunch, and after that he leaves to work. So I'm excited about that. So one thing I do want to tell you guys is that my husband's work schedule changed. And so now he leaves my home at 10:30 in the morning and he gets home a lot later, around 8:30 or 8:45 at night. So I have a lot of day to cover with my kiddos. It's different than my husband being at work at 4 o'clock in the morning and coming home at 2 in the afternoon. So there's more time, more hours in my day, which is why it works so perfect for me to do two curriculums, to enjoy two curriculums with them. And just make it all about Jesus. Make it all about the true meaning of Christmas for us. And I hope for you too. So let me show you the second one. Oh, I didn't want to forget. It also comes with a lot of printables for the kiddos. So they're all working on a staple. This is Jonah's and JJ's. And JL actually has to create his own staple from cardback. So eventually he's going to be coloring this. And then they both just worked on the manger today. All three of them actually. And JL worked on his manger there. So JL has to do a handmade one, and he had a choice to do it either flat or 3D, whatever he wanted. So this is what he chose. So that's what they're working on. And then my folder here just has it out of the printables that comes with their journals and the things that they have to, that they will need for the unit. So I love that they have their own Christmas cards already. And so today we wrote Christmas cards to encourage one of our friends. So that was a fun activity. So the kids all did their Christmas cards and they encouraged someone, and we're gonna mail these out. So I'm excited about that too. So I love that it comes with that as well. It makes it easier for you as a parent not have to buy cards or make cards. So that's a fun little addition. So that's the folder that I have for our Gather Around Christmas unit.